Hi, thank you for joining me today, and in this video I'm going to talk you through the four steps I use to arrange guitar parts for fingerstyle guitar. I'm going to talk you through this on the basis of a song. It's called So the song is We Wish You a Merry Christmas, and I'm going to talk you through the basis from learning the melody to playing this, what I just did. So all the tabs for this video are available at my Patreon page. But for this particular video, at the end of the year I thought, let's do a giveaway so everyone is getting the tabs. So now let's talk about the steps. Step one is getting yourself familiar with the melody and the chords. So you need to know the song, because you can't arrange it if you don't know the chords or the melody. So we're gonna learn the melody first. It's very simple, just read along with the tab. Alright, so that's the melody. And of course the next thing is the chords. It's C,
F, A minor, and then it's F, B, G, C.
So now we got the chords and the melody down. You know them. If you don't know them, don't continue, because it's useless. Now we go to the following step, step two. Play the melody accompanied by the bass note, the root note of the chord, and make sure the bass note rings through the entire bar, if possible. So now we're gonna have a little puzzle. How do we adjust the fingering of the melody that we can keep our bass note fretted? So for the first note, the open G string is played before the bar, so that's no bass note. And then we play the C. So the C bass note, you always want the lowest note possible as your root note, because that makes it sound full. So it's the third fret on the A string. And we're gonna play that note with our ring finger. And the melody we're gonna play with our index finger and our pinky. So you definitely need to get your pinky game on today. So for the entire bar, three counts, because it's a 3-4 time signature. 1, 2, 3. I'm keeping my ring finger pressed down on the third fret of the A string, whilst my index finger and pinky play the melody on the second string. It's not that difficult. The next chord was an F, so we're gonna need to play an F root note, which is the lowest I know, is fret 1 on the 6th string. You can also play fret 3 on the D string from this F chord, but that note isn't as full as the one on the 6th. And the melody note is fret 2 on the 3rd string, on the G string. So that's the second bar. Already sounds a lot more interesting than just playing the notes or the chords. Alright, so the next chord is the D chord. The lowest note of the D chord is the open D string. It's always very handy to have your open string as the root note, because you can just play an open string and all your fingers are free to do whatever they like. So the melody is, the next chord was a G, so our ring finger presses down this note, fret 3 on the low E string, which is our root note, the G. Now we play the B string and the G string as the melody notes. So it's not difficult at all. So from the D. Very good. So the next chord is an E. Of course we all know that the low E string is our root note. And the melody note is just on the first string, the high E string. 0, 0, 1, E, E, F, E again, and then D, the third fret on the B string. Now we go to A minor. which is the A string, also again very lucky. And then played fret 1 and 2 on the 2nd and the 3rd string. So just a small A minor chord. You can also just fret an A minor chord. And then 2 open G strings. And then we play an F, again the same as the 2nd bar. A D. Root D note and the octave fret 3 on the B string. Then the G chord, an open B string accompanied by the bass note, of course, again the G. And then we end on the C. So all together sounds like this, only the bass notes and a melody. So that's your first fingerstyle arrangement right there. It's very nice. So you don't have to do more than this. This could be very fun and appropriate for the song, but we're gonna do more in step 3. Try to incorporate chords in the mix. So now we only play the root note, but we're now gonna make it sound more full with the chords. And the rule is, try to play as much notes as possible in the chord without getting higher than the melody note, because you always register the highest note as being the melody. So if you top the melody with a chord note, people will think that is the melody, and that will probably muddle the melody a little bit. So, chords. The first note stays the same, the open G string. Now we're gonna play the C chord, and the highest melody note is on the B string. So we're gonna play the middle 4 strings with our thumb, index, middle, and ring finger. So we have a nice full sound. To make it a little more romantic, try playing it like that. So not like, but. And now you can just play the melody. So. Luckily, we don't need more fingers, only our pinky on the 2nd string. Sounds already very nice. So the next chord was an F. So for the F, it's always a bit difficult because you have multiple voicings you can use. You can play this one. It's not a bar chord because we aren't barring our index finger. You play fret 1 on the 6, the 6th string, the low E string, fret 3 and fret 3 on the A and the D string. And our middle finger plays the melody note, fret 2 on the G string. And then we use the same 4 fingers again, thumb, index, middle, ring. Three times the G string. So if you think this is too hard playing the F like this, you can always make it easier for yourself. Play this. It sounds less cool, but you have to work with what you can. You can't do the impossible. Okay, so the next chord was a D. So we're gonna play the lowest note again, this one, accompanied by fret 2 on the G string, which is the 5th. So now we play a small D chord without a 3rd, and then we're gonna play the melody again. Now we go to the G chord, which is always very easy because we've got lots of open strings in the chord. So we just omit the A string, but then we play the 6th, the 4th, the 3rd, and the 2nd string. The E, D, G, B. And the melody is like this. Alright, the next chord was an E chord. So the melody note is the 1st string, so I always try to keep those fingers together. So if my ring finger plays the 1st string, my middle finger plays the 2nd, my index finger plays the 3rd, my thumb is on the root note, the low E string. Then we use our index finger for the 1st fret. A minor. So just the middle 4 strings with the melody note on top, the 2nd string, and then the 3rd string. 2 times open G string, F, D, which we covered earlier, G, all also the same as we did earlier, and then a C again. Wow. All right, so that was step number three. So step four is get creative with what we've got. So we got chords, we got melody. It could sound boring, it could sound awesome, but you can always try to add a little bit more to the mix. So maybe some percussion, maybe some harmonics. Maybe you can alter the chords just a little bit so it sounds more awesome. So we're gonna try to do that for the C. It's fun to keep the bass note going on the 1, the 2, and the 3. So that's what I thought. 1, 2, on 2 we play the same bass note, and then we're gonna play the melody. So the melody plays eighth notes and our thumb plays quarter notes, so our fingers need to move a little bit faster. Instead of... Okay, so now we go to F. And to try to make it a little bit more interesting, I try to not have the same bass note pattern in a second chord. So I play the chord, melody note, and then the bass note, and then the melody again. So it falls in between the melody notes. Sounds very cool. So the next chord is a D. And for this chord goes, it's a little bit thin, because the F has lots of fat strings, and the D is a little bit higher up, so it can sound a little bit thin. So you can always, it could sound very good to alter the bass note of your chord with a note from the chord itself. So the D, if you know anything about chords, is made up of three notes, the D, the A, and the F sharp. You can play any of those as root note and it may sound very cool. And you really don't alter the chord because the same notes are being played, only with a different voicing. So for the D, you may have seen the D over F sharp chord, which is just a D with an F sharp as your root note. So for the guitar, that's very convenient because the F sharp is a very low note on the guitar. So you instantly make it sound much fuller. So we're gonna play that. So a D chord over F sharp. And then we're gonna play the melody. So it's like this, fret 2 on the low E string, open D string, fret 2 on the G string, and fret 3 on the B string. Then the melody is being played, but you need to fret it without your index finger, so you can use that for the melody. And now we can go to a G chord, which stays the same. For the D over F sharp, we're gonna use the same bass pattern as the first chord, so three notes on every beat. And the melody is the same rhythm as the first part as well. So that's not that hard if you got it down. And for the G, we use the same bass note pattern as the second bar. So it's the chord, the melody note, bass, melody note. So from the top, it sounds like this. So we notice we have an ascending bass line from F to F sharp, which is the third of the D, the third, 1, 3, 5, the G. Then we go to an E chord. So I thought it could be fun to make the third of the G chord, which is the G sharp, E, G sharp, and B, the three notes from the E chord, to make the G sharp our root note, because then we got an ascending bass line and we continue to keep it ascending. It's F sharp, F sharp, G, G sharp. And I know we're going to the A chord, so that's again an ascending bass line of five notes, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A. So that's gonna sound pretty awesome, but we need to play the E chord with the melody. So we're gonna play a different E chord. It's the C shape. This, 7 from the A string, and then 6 on the D string, 4 on the G string, and 2 on the B string. But we need the G sharp in the bass. So we're gonna play a bar with our index finger, covering the fourth fret on the low E string. Then we omit the A string, so you can dismiss your pinky. Makes it easier. So now we got an E over G sharp chord, which is a very nice pattern following the G chord. Cool. So now we need to play the melody over here with our fingers pressing down. Yes. So on the second string we play 5, fret 5, and with our pinky to 6 and back to 5 to our middle finger. And then our pinky plays fret 7 on the G string. It's the same rhythm as the first and the third bar, so we're gonna play the bass note on each quarter note. Cool. And now we're following up the pattern from G sharp to an A. And I play the A just as an open chord. So it's the same what we did earlier. Chord, melody note, third string, G, bass note, two open G strings. And then an F chord, D, but we can use a D over F sharp again. So that sounds fun. A G, resulting in a C. So what we got in total sounds like this. Sounds pretty cool, right? So we made it from a pretty boring-ish song to something that sounds pretty interesting played on guitar. And you can do the same with every song you know, because most songs are just made up of chords and melodies. Sometimes it could be a real puzzle figuring out what you can do, adding a percussion slap, Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something. And the more theory you know, the easier this gets. So make sure to learn music theory as well. It helps a great deal. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time with another video. This was Paul. Cheers.